Kelly. Understanding the mole seems like the hardest topic in all of chemistry, but don't worry, we'll help you make sense of it. Get ready for the simplest explanation of this topic you will find. A mole is just an amount of something. We use lots of words to mean a collection of a certain size. For example, dozen, bushel, or gaggle. In chemistry, we use the term mole. We say we want to express how much of something there is in relation to the number of atoms it has. It wouldn't make much sense to say how many grams of an element there is per ton of iron atoms. Clearly, the mass approach won't work with atoms having different atomic weights. In stoichiometry, which deals with exact ratios, we need to compare the same number of atoms of each element to get the ratios right for reactions. How do we do that? Moles. A man named Amadeo Avogadro expressed that there were 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd particles in a mole. This number allows us to compare the same number of atoms or molecules regardless of their size and molar mass. There are a couple of mass units used to weigh molecules. For example, the Dalton, which we commonly call the atomic mass unit. Each atom has an atomic mass listed in the periodic table that is unique to itself. That number means two things, however. The mass in grams of one mole of the atom and the atomic mass in Daltons, or atomic mass units. Avogadro's number defines a mole of any atom to be a specific number of atoms, so that the average molecular weight in Daltons equaled the number of grams that the same number of atoms would weigh. Avogadro's number does this for any atom or molecule of any atomic mass. While there are variations of mass units, Avogadro's number can unify the mass of atoms with differing atomic weights. Put simply, a mole is a collection of a specific number of molecules that helps us evenly compare atoms which have vastly different atomic masses. We can't weigh a mole, well, not the kind we're talking about. A mole is a number and not a mass. Because atoms and molecules are much too small to count, we have no practical choice but to weigh them, usually in grams. But we need to know about how many molecules or atoms are in a particular mass so that we know how they should react when mixed with other elements. Let's look at some examples. Here, we have a half mole of element A at 9 grams of mass and a half mole of element B at 3 grams of mass. The larger atoms have more protons and neutrons, so they weigh more in atomic mass. The number of atoms is determined by moles, not by grams. When element A reacts with element B to form a compound, you still have a half mole, but now it weighs a bit more after the reaction. Understand that the total mass of the protons and neutrons will be conserved through the reaction. Remember the law of conservation of mass. Other things like volume and moles are not conserved, but mass is always conserved. Now, let's look at another example and use Avogadro's number to tell us what to expect from a simple reaction. In this example, element A reacts with element B to form compound C. There are only 60 atoms of element A at the start, and we have to figure out how many moles of element B are needed and how many moles of compound C will be produced. We need Avogadro's number anytime we need to convert from atoms or molecules to moles. This lets us follow what chemists call the stoichiometry or ratio of the problem. The ratio of A to B in this example is 1 mole to 1 mole. The ratio of C to A is 2 moles for every 1 mole of A. So we'll multiply by that 2-to-1 ratio to get the correct number of moles of C produced. Using Avogadro's number helps us determine the formula weight. Let's say we know 13 grams of sodium reacted completely to form sodium chloride, and we need to find out how many molecules of sodium chloride that would produce. This is as simple as dividing 13 grams by the atomic mass of sodium, then multiplying this by Avogadro's number to convert to moles. But don't forget the critical step of using the stoichiometric ratio of moles of sodium to moles of sodium chloride. If you still have more questions or something is still unclear, take a look at the other lessons we have developed at Chegg or ask for help directly from one of the Chegg subject matter experts.